The party chair of presidential bet Francisco Isko Moreno issues a fresh challenge to survey frontrunner Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. to attend debates and answer allegations against him. This morning, we have with us Action Democratico Chairman Ernest Ramel. Mr. Ramel, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and good morning to everybody watching and listening right now.
All right, let's start first with the numbers. So Mayor Isko, he remains, at least with the last surveys that I've seen with SWS and Pulse, at number three, trailing behind VP Lenny. It seems he's never really recovered, and the trajectory from the shining star that he was has not recovered or bumped up, Mr. Ramel.
Well, that's what the SWS and Pulse Asia numbers were showing. But however, we have also we run our own surveys, internal numbers, and I think Mr. Dito Banayo also said this in some of the interviews that actually Mayor Isko has overtaken VP Lenny Robredo, albeit it's not that huge a lead, no, and he has been gaining 2-3 percentage points every week, whilst the front runner was also losing the same numbers, huh? And it's just showing that.
He is getting voters from Mr. Marcos.
It seems like that, and even the other surveys, SWS, Pulse, and so on, is showing that the top second choice is Mayor Isko Moreno. So. And then the soft voters of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Are going to Mayor Isko, no? So it seems like that's a pattern. Because I don't know if you believe this, but Pulse Asia's Tabunda, Miss Tabunda said that Mrs. Robredo's numbers has a cap, no? Vice President Lenny Robredo has a cap, may limit as to what vote she could get. And we also don't see that the numbers of the Marcos supporters will go to her, no? So I think that's the thing here. That's the interesting points at this time.
Okay. Now, in the latest rally, I mean, you have called that Mr. Marcos should attend debates. And not only that, in a forum, you've also reminded the public about Mr. Marcos's tax issues, educational background, track record, etc. Kumbaga, kayo ang tumitira.
Well, I felt like it's a duty as a political party that has a standard bearer in this race, no? That to point out these myths. Kasi alam mo, when you scan social media, yung mga supporters niya, whether they are real supporters or trolls, no, are spreading that wala namang kasalanan. Ang kasalanan ng ama ay hindi kasalanan ng anak. When in fact, no, ang daming kaso showing na he himself tried to withdraw money from the Swiss accounts. No? And may mga instances na ganun. And then, as sinasabi doon ng ibang mga supporters...
And he was the executor, just for the record. He was the executor of the estate. That's just a matter of record. Go on.
That's right. Tapos, may sinasabi rin sila na lahat ng kaso ng mga Marcoses ay dismissed, which is far from the fact. No? There are three cases that I can cite here. We already cited yung GR120880, yung estate tax, no, na sinasabi namin 200 billion. And Attorney Vic Rodriguez saying na wala pang finality ito. That's far from the truth. If you read the ruling, malinaw po doon sa dulo. Ang sabi po ng Supreme Court, it's already final and unappealable. I don't know kung saan galing si Mr. Vic Rodriguez, pero mukhang ang sinasabi niyang mga ongoing cases regarding this case is yung mga hinaharang nila na kinukuha ng assets nila. Yun yung pinag-aawayan pa ngayon. Pero as far as the Supreme Court is concerned, final na yung ruling doon sa estate. Ano? And there are other cases like yung GR189434, no? About naman the Arelma case, no? Where as of 1983, at that time, $3,369 ito. So nanalo rin ang ating gobyerno rito, it's a Supreme Court ruling na final and unappealable. And another one is GR 189434, another final and unappealable Supreme Court ruling. Sa Swiss account naman to, no, estimated at around, if I'm not mistaken, $658 million. So lahat ito ay naipanalo na ng ating gobyerno, at ang inaano na lang ngayon, ano ba nangyayari, no? So hinaharang nila lahat yung pag-seize ng assets nila, para yun yung nakatie up in litigation. Pero as far as these things are concerned, these are already final.
Okay. So, but then your statements would be much, I mean, would come out more powerful if it actually came from the presidential candidate you're supporting. So the question is, why is it you're playing hardball, you know, you and Mr. Banayo, and yet Manila Mayor Isko Moreno isn't speaking this stuff against the Marcoses? He's softballing everything.
Actually, we start, my statement came out in support of what he already said, na hahabulin niya yung 200 billion na hindi binabayaran ng mga Marcoses tungkol dito nga sa estate tax na ito, no, 1997 ruling pa, na 23 billion at that time. But with all the interests and penalties, now, as according to former Justice Antonio Carpio, is already at 200 billion. In fact, today, we are going to have a letter received sa commissioner ng BIR, Commissioner Dulay, number one, asking if they already, kasi kailangan every 5 years, nagbibigay ka ng demand letter dun sa heirs, no? Particularly the executor, which is Mr. Marcos Jr., no? Na kung nakapagbigay na sila, at kung hindi pa, it's their duty to again demand from the heirs. Otherwise, magiging uncollectable na itong pera na ito na dapat mapunta sana sa ayuda, makapagpatayo sana tayo ng pangarap ni Mayor Isko na 17 regional hospitals, no? Para world class, like yung hospital ng Maynila. Yun yung sinasabi natin. And may just add, tungkol naman doon sa kanyang executive capacity, no?
Okay, Mr.
Marcos Jr.
Mr. Ramel, okay, I just wanted to check.
Yes.
If your signal is okay, stable, go ahead. Continue. Okay.
Thank you. For 9 years, ano, and compared to Mayor Isko, been mayor for what? All less than 3 years. And yet, hindi mo maikumpara yung achievements ng dalawa. Mayor Isko has done so much for Manila. 7 housing projects, bagong ospital ng Maynila, all the parks were na binuhay, lahat ng mga public parks.
Okay. All right. Can we
Mayor Isko's time?
Yeah, go ahead. You know,
and
what?
Then,
no, I wanted to say your signal is a bit unstable.
I'm sorry.
In and out. Okay, but let's move back a little too. The fact is, you don't hear these statements from Mayor Isko himself. When he's interviewed, he doesn't really name Mr. Marcos. He doesn't attack Mr. Marcos in this way. He's viewed by some analysts as the centrist candidate. He's not seen as opposition.
Well, hindi naman talaga, even Action Democratico is not positioning itself as an opposition party. Yes, we in fact are centrist, but being centrist doesn't mean you do this ngayon. May mga
the team going on the offensive against Mr. Marcos. So let's continue our discussion, sir. Go ahead.
Yes, we're saying that we Mayor Isko has a position naman on a lot of issues. And in fact, he started the ball rolling with this estate tax. That's why we also felt that compelled to help him, no? Kasi maraming myths, eh, no? Na napapaniwalaan ng tao about yung dismiss lahat ng cases wherein these are 3 cases I cited na panalo ang Philippine government against them. Ang sabi nila ay ang kasalanan daw ng ama ay hindi kasalanan ng anak. Yes, that's true. But the son is also the executor of the state at siya ay nagtatry mag-withdraw ng pera. at sila ay nakikinabang dun sa largest na sinasabing kinuha ng kanilang ama. Lastly, they are also saying na na si Marcos has very good leadership skills, no? Pero sabi ko nga napatunayan 9 years na governor where ano yung malaki na proyekto na pinagmamalaki ni Mr. Marcos, yung Bangi Windmills na apparently hindi pala niya project. I think it was back in 2010 when you interviewed him and he said that, ano? Yun yung ginagamit ngayon na sinabi niya it's a commercial enterprise. But I went one step further. Meron akong nakita ang Philippine Star article back in October 13, 2005, no? Sinabi niya, no, under this headline, Giant Windmills Energize Ilocos Norte. Mismo sinabi niya from his mouth, frankly, if there's money to be made, the province would have involved itself. So napakalinaw, hindi niya ito i-proyekto. And yet, nakikita mo ngayon, yun yung gilagambit niya sa commercial niya. Meron siyang dalawang white elephant projects, yun, Dayapan Center at isang convention center at hotel, na sinasabi ngayon ng former Governor Fariñas are white elephant projects. Walang pakinabang yung kanyang gobyerno. Contrast that to the two-year performance of Mayor Isko, ang dami ginawa, di ba, nasaid ko na kanina, no? Mm-mm. So, this shows how will they run the country, no? 9 years Ilocos Norte governor and you have 6 years to run this country and yet you have nothing to show. Paano mo ngayon ipapakita sa tao na you're better, you're the okay, best qualified candidate to get this country out of the pandemic crisis we are in?
All right. So Mr. Ramel, with everything you've just mentioned, the fact remains that the COMELEC has allowed Mr. Marcos to run for president. His name will be included in the ballot. Of course, the NBank will still decide, but then that could take months, even maybe after the elections. So what happens now? What I guess my last question is clearly you are wooing the Solid North. I saw parts of Isko's speech in an article right now. But what is moving forward? What moves are you planning to take?
Well, obviously, si Mayor Isko, sinasabi naman niya, ang importante sa kanya yung endorsement ni Juan de la Cruz, ni Petra, ni everyday Filipinos. No? So that's why, sipag lang siya.
Duterte? What about President Duterte's endorsement? Are you still courting that?
Well, ang importante sa amin, kung iboboto ni President Duterte si Mayor Isko, that's one vote right there. No? So, it's okay. Kung makakatulong, kung iboboto niya, no, may bagay 'yon. So we all ang isang boto ay mahalaga, no. If President Rodrigo Duterte and his party allies will say na they will vote for him.
The president carries Isko Sara. What happens to Dr. Willie Ong, who you all admitted you did not bring to Mindanao on purpose?
Yes, si Doc Willie Ong, ang slang ng partido dyan, siya talagang official vice presidential candidate. No matter who the others are pairing Mayor Isko with. I-pair man yan kay SP Dito Soto, kay Mayor Sara Duterte. Kami naman, kalayaan naman yan ng lahat ng mga organisasyon, political parties to do so. So we respect that. And it's a positive thing for Mayor Isko kasi ibig sabihin meron talagang bandwagon. May sumasama, may sumasali. Ang mahirap yung inaalisan ka this time, no? Rather than may mga umaalis, kung may mga dumadagdag, that's a very positive thing, no? Na ipapakita na may solidong suporta sa ground si Mayor Isko Moreno.
Okay. So are you courting President Duterte's endorsement?
To be honest, no?
The organization.
We are not positively courting the support, no? Ang tingin namin kung bibigyan kami ng boto ni President Duterte, that's baga bonus na 'yon. Maraming salamat po President Duterte kung boboto niyo po si Mayor Isko among others, ano? Even yung mga nasa PDP laban. I think kahapon meron silang proclamation rally of sorts, no? Where you saw siguro may mga hawak-hawak na parang hand sign na malaking materials yung mga tao doon. One was a fist bump. One was first hand sign, ano, na malalaki. I don't know kung sa kanila galing yun, nakalagay PDP laban, ano. So I don't know if that's the indication that they will support Mayor Scott, but if that's the indication, then very, very much welcome. Okay. Thank you very much.
Next, my last question is Cebu. Do you already have won Cebu's endorsement?
Currently, patuloy yung pakikipag-usap, ano? Pero sa akin, malinaw naman na the presence of Congressman PJ Garcia in our proclamation rally speaks well. Ibig sabihin, may malaking window, no? Dahil andun yung Secretary General ng Juan Cebu. Of course, in his personal capacity, supporting the presidential candidacy of Mayor Scott Moreno Dumagoso.
On that note, thank you so much for joining me today, Mr. Ramel, Chairman of Aksyon Demokratiko. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure.